So I'm delighted that we're able to come and talk to the developer community today, and I'm really, really excited about the prospects of what we will, I'm sure, achieve over the next 24 hours or so.
I'm Steve Jones. I work in the RNIB innovation team. A hackathon is where we invite developers to assemble, and we try and provide them with some information about some of the issues that blind and partially sighted people face when using mobile devices.
I'm Vanya Sudar. I'm totally blind. Although there are a lot of apps that work absolutely great and are accessible, and I find there is a number of them that is not, and that can be very frustrating, because sometimes you find something on something like Android Market and you think, oh, this is going to be very useful, and then you realize that the app doesn't work, whether because the text is not spoken to the screen reader or buttons are unlabeled, and you just, you know, walk around and sort of work around your screen and you just hear button or image, but you have no idea what's happening.
I'm Robin Spinks, Principal Manager for Digital Accessibility at RNIB. Today's event is really quite a unique opportunity for mobile developers and for blind and partially sighted people and usability and accessibility specialists to come together and to congregate around a common goal and collaborate to make applications. So it's a really unique environment in which people can bounce ideas off one another.
Let's say train timetable, so it could tell me, I don't know, the nearest train station is this and that, and then you could type in, you know, but I want to go to Manchester, so it will tell you, you can get to Euston by going there and there and there, and the next train is at such and such time.
If we look at an example of an app like Train Times on the iPhone, it's possible for a blind person to navigate that app and to use it independently simply by using their finger and sliding it across the touchscreen. And they will have, the app will speak to them, it will tell them what they're covering.
Destination station, Peterborough, Outwich, arriving, tap, last, tap, find trains, Glutton. Direct service from London King's Cross.
I'm really pleased that so many app developers came, because sometimes you wonder kind of like, well, do they really care? And I think that so many showed up that I think they do.
Hi, I'm Kevin. I'm CEO of Navoda here in London. We make Android apps.
It's been good. The atmosphere through the night has been up, but then it's been down because everyone gets really tired. We've got actual products that we've made, and we've been using sim specs to simulate like what it's like to have disabilities, and we're all very excited for the presentations.
We made an application to help visually impaired users plan what they want to watch on TV, as the existing TV guides were inaccessible to visually impaired screen readers.
The problem we're trying to solve is that of blind and partially sighted individuals having independence to walk around. We solve this with a mobile app which will tell you what's around you as you're walking along.
I did a really simple app to detect colour, mainly for money. You hold a note up to your phone and it just audibly tells you whether it's a £5 note, a £10 note or a £20 note.
For the world's 285 million blind and partially sighted people, a world of accessible mobile technology can be quite life transforming.
To find out more about making mobile apps accessible to blind and partially sighted users, please visit our website at rnib.org.uk/innovation or call 01733 375 012.
RNIB, supporting blind and partially sighted people.